This is the Irish Rover. The Irish Rover in 1995 was a two-year-old Irish Draught Stallion, one of only two registrable stallions currently in the United States. He is shown here at a show, and although he is not qualified for the show that he's in, he's not a sport horse, he is a stallion of tremendous size and quality, of a breed that is on the verge of extinction, and he's here to add size, stamina, to the American thoroughbred and calm temperament. The first pictures we see of him here is as a yearling when he first arrived in Texas from Ireland in January of 1995. He is a young horse of tremendous bulk. He currently at age two has 11 1/4 inch cannon bone. He comes from a very strong mare, Nacavera Pride. In 1982 and 83, she was the mare champion at the RDS in Dublin. In 1989, because of the points of her offspring, Nacavera Pride went on to become Brood Mare of the Year for the Irish Draught Horse. His sire, Kildalton Gold, was the 1988 and 89 champion stallion at the RDS in Dublin. He is currently the leading sire of performance horses under the age of 10 in Ireland. The other nine horses on the top 10 list are all thoroughbreds. What this animal possesses is elegant movement, tremendous bone, and a very calm temperament. As we see him here, he seems to move with a floating action, obviously coming down from the dam side. A half-brother to this horse is a horse that is in England who was used as nothing but a dressage specialist, and is a horse that you can just see has the elegance that we need for crossing on thoroughbreds to produce the type of sport horses that this country needs. In 1995, the U.S. Equestrian three-day team has been selected as of September of this year to go to Europe. Three of the four horses on that team are Irish Draught crosses. Custom-made, the horse that won Rolex Kentucky in 1995, ridden by David O'Connor, is a thoroughbred draft cross. The horse his wife rides, Biko, is a 3/4 thoroughbred, 1/4 Irish draft, according to the Irish Horse Board. It was a bronze medalist at badminton. And Bruce Davison is currently riding a horse called Eagle Lion that he won badminton on. To have a breed that puts so much emphasis on sport horses relative to their numbers and size is just phenomenal. The Irish Draught currently is the one horse on the at-risk list of the Rare Survival Trust for horses. There are only 99 stallions registered in the world right now. And the breed is on the verge of extinction, but still, the Irish government is doing their best to save it. They think they will be successful. But as you look at this horse now, as he approaches, he is currently shown in the pasture as a two-year-old, 8 months after he arrived in the United States. And as he matures, even though he's a young horse, he looks totally different than he did as a year. The only show that he's been in, and basically the only time out in public, as you'll see later in the tape, was just strictly a sport horse show where he was judged on confirmation to be a sport horse, primarily a dressage horse. He was competing with all warm bloods, but still handled himself both as a gentleman and impressed the judges, even though he was the type of horse that was not what they were looking for. But he is the type of horse that the American thoroughbred owner and inventor is looking for. And he is one of only two in this country that will be registered in the near future, and one of probably only four in existence on the North American continent. But as you see him move, the grace he shows, the power, he will be available here for quite some time. He was sent over by the Irish government as a backup to an initial program in 1994. That bred 1,000 breedings were presented to breed American thoroughbreds to produce sport horses. With a live foal guarantee, they decided to send a stallion as a backup, and he was shown 7 times before he left Ireland. He's been champion all 7 times, including 1993. He won the silver trophy as the outstanding foal of the breed. The Irish draft horse is a little-known horse to the average American. Matter of fact, the average American horseman is not very familiar with the Irish draft. He's a breed that goes back 400 years. He comes from a crossing of Norman war horses from the Middle Ages that were brought over to Ireland at the time of the Norman invasion of England and Ireland. There's a mixture of the Irish hobby, the Connemara pony, and sometime about 200 years ago, there were some Andalus stallions that came off of a Spanish shipwreck off the coast of Cork that made their way onto Ireland. And over time, this horse developed into the horse that he is today because of Ireland's position with mostly small farms. The men had a tendency to either work for other large landholders or work in town. Women and children wound up working the farms with the horses, and over a long period of time this animal was bred to be very obedient, to work for women and children. The Irish didn't tolerate what they call slacker, a horse that wouldn't work, or a lasher, a horse that would kick out or endanger the women, was never bred again. So out of necessity they bred all bad temperament out of the breed. The Irish draft horse has gone down substantially in numbers. At the end of World War II, there were about 500,000 Irish draft horses in Ireland and England. Because of the late mechanization of the small Irish farm, their chief trading partner was Great Britain, and during the 30s and 40s, they had geared up for armament production, so small tractors weren't in abundance and readily available. And they didn't really become available in any large numbers until the 1950s. At that time, the Irish draft numbers started to decline. There was a tremendous shortage of food in Europe. A lot of the older mares were sent over to Europe for human consumption. The rest of the higher quality draft mares and stallions were crossed with thoroughbreds to produce jumping horses. With all the new leisure time that was available to both England, North America, and Ireland, hunting resumed. The demand for these horses was substantial, and over the last 40 years they have produced some of the best jumping horses the world has ever seen. But in the process they almost bred themselves to extinction by crossing with thoroughbreds. They have made substantial corrections. There are currently 836 registered mares left in the breed. There are 99 stallions. And in this current process, about 600 mares last year were bred for pureblood stallions. The government is doing what they can to encourage people to save the breed. It is the national horse of Ireland. It is the one horse that is their claim to fame for all of the horses that they're producing around the world that are jumpers and three-day eventers. The Irish government, even though the numbers are few, last year they only passed 5 stallions for inspection into the herd book. The traits they look for are substantial quality, perfect conformation, and as you see here and in other tapes, if you ever see an Irish horse, the Irish people are not afraid to run their horse directly at a camera or directly away from it. the movement is all important to the breed. Confirmation is next. Probably the least emphasis is placed on looks. And as a result, you'll find some of these horses with bigger hooves than the Americans are used to, or larger warm blood type heads, which to a thoroughbred lover is, looks a little different and not what they're initially looking for. But the one thing to keep in mind, over the last 10 years, about 2,000 of these half-blood animals have made their way into the United States. You can read the Chronicle of the Horse or any other national sales magazine on horses, and you will never find one for sale. Once somebody owns one of these animals, they never give it up. They have the calm temperament that will calm down the most impetuous thoroughbred. If you're looking for a horse for children to ride or to learn to event on that will not only be a substantial horse to be mounted on, but one that will pretty much take care of the rider, this is the breed to cross on your thoroughbred. As you can see in this tape, as he's moving, the horse is just basically, even as a young animal, moves just straight as a string. This happens to be a very large stallion. He currently stands 17 hands, and he's 1,670 pounds, and he has not yet reached his third birthday. In 1995, an initial program that was worked out with the Irish Horse Board and the Irish Draught Horse Society, SEMA was shipped over. 23 mares were bred and had Irish Draught half-blood foals in this country. During the 1995 year, another 100 or so mares were bred, and the semen was eventually used up on that program, and since this horse was sent over as a backup stallion to the program, he is now one of the two stallions that will be staying here. He will be available initially to 40 mares for 1996, until such time as we find out if he's old enough to freeze semen. If he is, we will have unlimited bookings to him. If not, it'll be on a first-come, first-served basis to the first 40 mares that their owners apply for. One of the most surprising things that people say to me when they see one of these horses is they see a 1,700 pound animal that can move like a pony, because when the word Irish Draught is mentioned, it conjures up in their mind a horse similar in structure to a Percheron or a Shire or a Clydesdale, and nothing could be further from the truth for this particular breed. At the trot, they do not hit heel first, like most draft horses do. They move on their toes, and as you see as he goes by, he has a sloping shoulder similar to the thoroughbred. That's why they cross so well. And it is still the undisputed cross-country riding champ in the world. There's nobody who has ever ridden one who even doubts that this horse is the best horse for cross-country riding just for pleasure. He's a hunt horse without peer, and his accomplishments in the three-day field are legendary. Here he is at an Oldenburg curing. As a producer of sport horses, this breed has phenomenal success. Nelson and Rodrigo Paseo, the father and son team that ride for Brazil, this year won gold medal at the Pan Am Games in Argentina. Both of them riding Irish Draught crosses. One rode Tomboy, the other one rode Spring Elegance. North American Show Jumping Championship in 1995 up at Spruce Meadows in Canada was won by a horse called Cagney. He is the son of an Irish Draught stallion called Clover Hill. Badminton and Rolex this year were won by horses that have thoroughbred Irish Draught backgrounds. There isn't a major event in 1995 that this breed missed the winner's circle in.
Watch the street. Yeah.
Now you have had a chance to look at the Irish Rover. As a two-year-old stallion, he's everything that I think the American event community is hoping for, especially with fine bone and excitable thoroughbred mares. He seems to be the perfect horse to cross. Starting in February of 1996, he will be available at a breeding fee of $1,000 with a live foal guarantee. And I hope he does everything for you that the breed itself has done for the international sport horse world.